early hours of Sunday afternoon, I was rudely awakened by a phone call from the city inspector. I tried to tell him I'd been enjoying my retirement, but he ordered me to finish replacing the wheels on my car and get back to work. A spate of recent homicides had piqued his attention due to a common factor. All the victims were dead. I knew that to crack open the streets of this city, I'd need to visit an old flame that had all but gone out. She had legs, like two parallel flesh-covered appendages, joining her feet of nature to a waist that screamed, "Waste not." Her brunette locks held the key to my desire, and the pupils in her eyes were the ones teaching me. I could tell that she'd been waiting for this moment by the way that she said, "You're late." Set me down for a stiff drink and a swift think. This lady had everything but the kitchen sink. I can't believe I wound up unwinding in her company once again, but I needed her help to unravel the tangled mysteries in this furball of a case. Like a kite in a cyclone, held by a small child no older than 5, I was hanging on by a thread. I was nothing but a curious ball of lint rolled into this city's ominous underbelly. What did it all mean? She left the room for a minute, though it felt like 60 seconds. I looked over my notes for a melody, and the percussion section had left me a cymbal. Something was up, and it's about to go down.